Hello everyone, Pilothenic here with another 1v1 tournament match between Cubit and Rhahi. Two games set, we're just getting started here. And here we are on Mars for the first match, one of two between Cubit and Rhahi. We have Expansives, Scavengers, Scientists, and Elites. Now what do we have in terms of founding locations over here? Maybe two potential scavenger spots, except for the underground nukes. That's a hesitation there. Might be able to squeeze in a scientist over here a little bit to get to the water, but you do have this dry ice, which makes making carbon stuff a lot more interesting. So we might see something go over in that location. Elites could be a possibility. I'm not entirely seeing it though. Rhahi is deciding to brave the nukes as a scavenger, and then Cubit's going for an expansive over here, which also makes sense, right next to everything that you need as an expansive. And Cubit upgrading to HQ1 first almost immediately. Rhahi following soon after. Rhahi did take this for $12,000, which seems like a reasonable price, I suppose. Does have the slight problem of only having a medium carbon there. See, Rahi's going, deciding not to go for that claim, going immediately into double metal mines. And then Cubit over here moving into a couple steel mills, some solar condensers for carbon, and then a bunch of metal here. Interesting choice to go for the metal mines. Double iron, but only go for two steel mills. Now steel is cheap, so that's probably why that happened. Also, I thought for sure I had that option set. We'll see if I can fix that later. Rhahi moving into the first water pump, making a decent bit of cash, $40 per second on that water pump here. Let's see, Cubit does need 13k for the upgrade, has 5. Rhahi needs less, 6.5k for the upgrade, has 5. So that upgrade for Rhahi will be coming out shortly. There's a transition in the steel mills that I was expecting to see from Cubit. Rhahi HQ3 moving into the more elemental quarries to get all that carbon and just race ahead through the upgrade. Food's starting to go expensive here, so I wouldn't be surprised to see some of our players move into food into HQ3. Cubit still lagging just a little bit in the upgrades, as to be expected, as the expansive needs some more steel to come in. Does have both of those steel mills, pairs of steel mills up and running. And that should be rectified in just a minute. Now switching over out of aluminum into glass kilns, as aluminum is dirt cheap. And Cubit already has 300 syrup. Rhahi's not really making any money over here. She is moving into some glass kilns as well. Went into silicon. And then I would like to see a move into glass, as carbon is dirt cheap and isn't really making Rhahi any money either. Farms, but maybe that's what the glass kilns are up to, get the glass so that farms could be a possibility. Also, upgrading is going to be difficult here. Available for option. Geotherm. Both players actually quite interested in this. Geotherm's power is getting a little bit up in price, and constructing a geotherm is going to be absolutely dirt cheap. 0.7k for Rhahi and 1.6k for Cubit. Cubit's going to take it for 32,000 though. That seems like it might be a little bit on the high side. We'll have to see though. Not much black market so far, in part because there are not a lot of money on this map right now, outside of food and glass, to use the black market. Cubit finally upgrading to HQ3, moving into some farms right here. I like this move from Cubit. Just moving into some of the best profit-making opportunities on the map right now, and Rhahi has finally switched into farm, greenhouse farms as well. Rhahi, first off, with the black market attack freezing these farms and steel mills and geotherms, are actually a quite effective freeze from Rhahi, but Cubit is just going to transition the farms over on the opposite side of his base. Plenty of claims to do that, has an expansive, and Cubit does have the upgrade to Rhahi gets the upgrade HQ4 on the schedule right now. Claims a geotherm of her own with that really cheap geotherm now, 4.8k or whatever. Shortage. Let's see who buys into stuff and who doesn't. Neither player really has enough cash in hand to do much buying. So nobody really taking advantage of that shortage there, as this is a pretty low cash game. Goon Squad coming out onto the greenhouse farms for Rhahi. Cubit still lagging behind here, in a large part because of this excellent freeze. Needs 31k for the upgrade, only has a 9k. Freezes Rhahi and only gets the one greenhouse farm thanks to that well-placed goon. So Cupid's not going to be very happy about that. Rahi's geotherm is almost online and is online now making her a little bit of power money that's going to pay down debt. Rhahi in A debt, Cubit in B debt at 72k. Neither player's debt is a problem at the moment. Cubit going back into metal mines for the aluminum. I guess it makes sense. Aluminum did creep back up to $40 for this very high without adjacency. New building is available. And then Rhahi continues to lead right now. She does need $47,000 worth of carbon, though, and only has these two carbon elemental quarries right here to get that carbon. So it's going to be quite a while before she's able to get to the upgrade. That being said, she is ahead in Cubit in both HQ level and cash on hand and debt, so that's always a nice place to be when you're scavenger versus an expansive in a 1v1 situation. Congratulations. She picks up the Pleasure Dome for $36,000, which seems like a lot. Those Pleasure Dome that's only making 148 and losing you $120 a second to debt. But Rhahi can afford it with her geotherm, as could Cubit, so it's not too bad. This just put Rhahi in $95,000 worth of debt versus Cubit's $65,000 in debt. Cubit still unable to get to the next HQ, needs 15k in glass. Silicon's expensive, and glass is really expensive, so not to mention it is a glass colony, so it's a little bit hard for Cubit to get upgraded, but does finally manage to get the HQ4 and is now $50,000 behind in Rhahi. Rhahi does have the option to upgrade to HQ5 right now if she so chooses, but instead, nope, there she goes, pulling the trigger, debating for it just a little bit. Moving into some more water. That's very far away, and that's going to use a lot of shipping, and this fuel is not entirely cheap at the moment. So Rhahi does need to have some sort of strategy to deal with that. She is going into a third elemental quarry just to get up this carbon and earn some of that upgrading cost back. Not entirely time to turn on the reactor. Cubit's gone into securing all the water that he needs, has some remote electrolysis reactors, and these steel mills aren't really doing anything. Steel's gone all the way down to well-placed freeze by Rhahi onto Cubit's water. That's going to eliminate a source of income for Cubit. Freeze on Rahi's elemental quarries. That doesn't hurt Rhahi in terms of that bad, but it is an annoyance. Water has gone through the roof As a cubit is consuming 0.6 per second, this is just from HQ, and it looks like Rhahi has purchased a little bit. Rhahi getting close to being able to think about majority buying cubit out. 60k, that is just under 3 shares of stock for cubit, so just under half of the way there.
The black market is open for business.
Power surge for Rhahi on to cubit, this time on the solar condensers, just going after cubit's source of cash. Cubit does need to figure out some way to get some cash here. Does have a pleasure dome of his own, but cubit deciding that the game is over with Rhahi at 60% of the buy and surrenders. Good game from both our players. Rhahi just abusing the fact that cubit is not in very many sources of money, and then cubit not defending his water whatsoever allowed Rhahi basically shut down all of cubit's income. And then interesting choice, cubit never deciding to go for silicon even though it's not too far away, and glass remaining really high as it is a glass colony, so that might have been a long-term mistake from cubit in this game. Well played, Rhahi, and we're going to go on to game number 2. But first, let's maybe take a look at some charts and graphs, see if they say show us anything, and then we'll go to game number 2. Anything that jumps out here. Nothing stands out completely from there, but just overall well-played game from Rhahi. Game 2 in this 2-game series between Rhahi and cubit in the group stage of the January 2018, or Winter 2018 Winter Cup. Rhahi did take game number 1 over cubit. So the question is, can cubit bounce back in this second match? We do have Scavenger, Scientists, Nomads, and Elites are available. Not a lot of iron, and it's not in a really good location. We do have a couple of possible founds for scavengers, especially because there are no nukes on the map. This one's by more water, but this one's by a wider distribution of resources, so I think I like this one better. And cubit agrees with me, taking it for $28,000 in debt. I'm not sure it's $28,000 better, but we'll have to see how this turns out. Now, Rhahi isn't that far away from aluminum, it's only a medium. The issue that she may run into is silicon access. Cubit does have much better silicon access. Well, that's a medium, yeah. I guess Rhahi is going to go long distance for her aluminum rather than going for the less shipping. And then cubit here, getting some very short shipping, upgrading HQ2 first. Going for some more aluminum, which is good in the short term, but could be a problem in the late term. Both players making potentially questionable moves in their aluminum at this point. Rhahi upgrading HQ2, moving immediately into a bunch of water. And water's decently priced, so Rhahi could make some money off of that if needed. In the short term, she's currently trying to buy up her glass before cubit buys up his glass, right? Or did I get that backwards? I'm not entirely sure which player started buying up glass first, but they're both trying to buy up glass before the other gets too expensive. Cubit going into a HQ2 geotherm that was pretty cheap to put down, only 2.2k or whatever. It is a power colony. Rhahi also thinking about going for an HQ2 geotherm. With power this high and the construction resources this cheap, I actually don't mind it. Cubit immediately mutinying Rahi's geotherm before it even has a chance to be built. So Rhahi does have the opportunity now to mutiny Cubit's geotherm here.
A scavenger HQ has been upgraded.
Does have 4K in cash, but deciding not to do that. Cubit does get to HQ3 first, moving into some electrolysis reactors, which are the best profit-producing buildings on the map right now, outside of the aluminum, now that Rahi's upgraded HQ3. Rahi moving into some more water, lots of water. Which is an interesting choice, because water is... Rahi has a lot of water. Water's not that expensive. Yeah, she's a... I guess it was just a short-term... I'm not entirely sure why. Also curious that Rahi's not contesting this geotherm mutiny whatsoever.
A new claim is available for auction.
Cubit does not have enough water. Not by much, so as Cat notes, that is in chat, that is an opportunity that Rahi could potentially use to get ahead once she actually has money to buy into water, because you know, we're sitting on 4K worth of resources right now, and most of that is in fact in water. $32,000 for the extra claim. Rahi deciding it is worth that, and she just wants more money. Going into all the water. Nope, now deciding to go into electrolysis. Probably worth denying the water, assuming that that just forces Cubit to use a claim from his upgrade on the water here. Cubit also going into some silicon. Power's still refusing to fall, despite the colony not adding any more offices here. Cubit's water gets frozen by an EMP, but Cubit going into a triangle of water early, so Cubit still having water issues, and Rahi now with enough money to buy up some of Cubit's water. And then Cubit responding in kind by freezing all of Rahi's production here. Venturing on the electrolysis instead of maybe the water. Either way, good freeze. Rahi has $61,000 of debt and now just caught up to Cubit in headquarters, and actually is only is ahead of Cubit in terms of cash on hand, as Cubit is needing to purchase a decent amount of expensive water, but now that this freeze is coming undone, or ending, I should say, Cubit should be making positive water once again very soon. Rahi, of course, is up from claims. Cat does have the count 3 claims, so that's always a good place to be. As a scavenger against another scavenger, these EMPs keep on coming. Rahi's buildings are all very clumped right now, and she is starting to rectify that by building out this way. That makes these EMPs pretty useful. Pirates coming out from Rahi, probably gonna go on the water.
The black market is open for business.
Well, she bought the pirates, but hasn't placed them yet. Nope, going for the glass. Wanted to get a nice shipment of glass here.
Let the bidding begin.
Superconductor coming out. That doesn't really help any players in their current base configuration. We'll see how high it goes. Maybe somewhere in the teens or 20s is where I was gonna guess. Well, this does give Rahi potentially the means to deal with the debt difference, although right now B debt versus AA debt, not that big of an issue. Cubit pushes the HQ5 first and gets rid of that pirate by creating some more greenhouse farms. And those greenhouse farms make a good EMP target, as Rahi shows. Rahi needs 16K for the upgrade, has 17K in the bank if she sold down resources correctly, there's that upgrade button, upgrading to HQ5, and then only 6k behind in cash on hand from Cubit, so it's going to be a pretty close game. And as noted already, Rhahi does have a claim advantage over Cubit, moving into the Pleasure Dome to challenge Cubit's Pleasure Dome. Interesting mutiny from Cubit, but fuel's cheap, so that's probably why. Doesn't really hurt Cubit too much, and denies some water from Rhahi, but it gets mutinied right back. Cubit right now with the slight advantage in cash on hand, some shortages here.
The Pleasure Dome is completed.
Coming through, and that means that Cubit's advantage has disappeared very quickly. In part probably because the Pleasure Dome just got completed, but that Pleasure Dome is making a decent amount of money right now, almost $200 a second. Rhahi still hasn't decided to move into that second or challenging Pleasure Dome, and that there she goes. Cubit with an optimization center up as well. Rhahi moving into Chems. Optimization center isn't quite completed yet.
Optimization center is ready. Time to start.
There are
everything.
Five resources above $100. Yeah, I'm a bit surprised that there's no hacker array yet either. Cat. I would expect to see that out, especially because no Rahi's in silicon as well. A hacker array and then moving into iron, or neither player's in iron, so whoever gets a bigger stockpile of iron first could easily use that for the hacker array. The auction code has decided that players are letting power get too high, or remain too high, and so a geothermal tile comes out, and Cubit looks like he's going to snag it for 28k.
Sold.
This neck and neck race between Rhahi and Cubit here. Hard to tell who's going to win it. Rhahi building one solar panel to take advantage of the superconductor, and then an optimization center as well. Our Pleasure Dome is coming online. Our players are neck and neck at this point in terms of current earnings. Cubit moving into a patent lab. Be interesting to see what Cubit decides to prioritize. Rhahi mutinying Cubit's optimization center, starting to research the optimizations in power, food, and chemicals. Power's on its way down, though, so I'm not sure that actually optimizing power is the best idea, as there's now too much power production on the map and not enough office module. The colony has not been growing as offices. But with Might, the power price is recovering just a little bit, so maybe Rhahi can take the edge off of her debt. Mutinies abound right now. Cubit mutinying Rahi's optimization center, and then Rhahi mutinying Cubit's patent lab, and immediately going into thinking machines. Rhahi with some good spies out here right now, able to tell what the patent lab, that the patent lab's undefended, going into thinking machines and nanotech. We haven't looked at off-world prices yet. 30k launches for oxygen, 26k launches for the food right now, and then 49k in terms of getting those offloads up, so we might see a offload game from Rhahi. And it is New Chicago, so it was a power colony from the beginning, to answer the question, Cat. But both players still neck and neck in terms of cash on hand. Power price is going to die very soon, and
auction.
The game agrees. Why isn't there a hacker array? So a hacker array up for auction. What would you pay for it? More than 14k, that's for sure. somewhere in the high 20s, I'd expect. Both players are in B, so it could go higher. $28K to Rahi. Will Cubit take it for 32? Yes, 32 for Cubit. How about 36? 32 is what the hacker array goes for. And now Cubit has a great short-term tool here. Rahi deciding to mutiny the patent lab and mutiny goons onto that patent lab. So Cubit donating a mutiny over to Rahi. We're going to have, it looks like, a hacker array versus off-world battle, but right now Cubit not hacking anything. And that mutiny was not cheap, as Cat pointed out.
Let's continue to improve.
In chat, it is a 50k mutiny, although Cubit would have bought it for less. Or would it be 50k? I'm not sure. Someone in chat correct me about that, please. Rahi does get thinking machines and going for nanotech and also going to try and get virtual reality as well.
The black market is,
we'll see if he's able to do that. Cubit is optimizing. What has Cubit been optimizing? Cubit with a bunch of optimizations queued up. Chemicals, glass, fuel, and power. Some of those are... I'm sorry, this is Rahi. Yeah, chemicals seems to be a mistake because the chemical price is artificially high right now. Cubit's actually the first to move into the cheap off-worlds and is hacking down chemicals. So despite Rahi having think machines, hasn't gone into a off-world market just yet. Some of these optimizations are definitely a little bit questionable here from Rahi. We'll see if that hurts her in the long term or not. Patent Lab is defended for now. We'll see if Cubit decides to start researching anything with it or is just more interested in the off-world market. How much does that off-world market cost Cubit right now to construct? 52k, so that'll be 52k out of the bank.
Off-world market is assembled.
Yeah, so only down to 59k, so Cubit can easily defend himself. Yeah, chemical optimizations are a long-term play to go into optimizations in general, but Rahi just has so many chems right now. I think I would have liked to have focused on different optimizations first. Virtual reality going to Rahi for 24k. And then we do have some freezes back again on Rahi's base. How much does it cost Rahi to put up a off-world market? 50k. I think I'd like to see her move into that off-world market, especially with thinking machines here. And it looks like she's getting ready to do that. But that's still pretty cheap for an off-world market when off-world launches are giving you 39, 38k, 35k, that's 1.5 launches before that off-world pays for itself. Right, he has spied out Cubit's hacker array. Financial instruments goes to Cubit, and Rahi did beat through Cubit's off-world and has mutinied it. Rahi says, oops. Not sure what that was about.
Price manipulations to begin shortly.
And now this, still 50k for the off-world. Yeah, me either. I don't know why she's saying oops.
Perhaps a lesson is in order.
Another mutiny goon. from Rhahi. Cubit not using the spy to double check and donating a very expensive mutiny over to Rhahi. That's a 60k swing in Rahi's favor once you subtract the cost of the goon, which was somewhere in the 20s, so that's a 40k favor swing. Oh, you can't spy your own building, that's right, but you can network. But if it's Rahi's, can you spy Rahi's building? Since she mutinied it? You can at least network virus it first. Anyway, Rhahi does have an aqua market of her own under construction.
Such a wonderful plot of land.
So that's a little bit on the late side, but this does look like the two offworlds will put Rhahi in a good position to win this game in the long run. Rahi's still optimizing, now optimizing food and oxygen, all the life support markets, which will make sense as those are the launches. High water tile all the way over here, up for auction. Rhahi mutinying everything, mutinying Cubit's pleasure dome, and each mutiny is going to have to start to wonder if there's a goon there waiting for him to donate another mutiny to Rhahi, and Cubit finds himself in D-Debt. Not a place you want to be in a 1v1 situation. Rahi's going for the kill. Cubit doesn't quite have enough cash to defend himself. Did see another goon did appear from Cubit on there, so spent a decent amount of money. Cubit, I guess, did have enough cash to defend himself. I wasn't paying attention to that closely enough. My apologies. But Rhahi does look like she has the long-term advantages here, matching Cubit off of off-world, and does have more cash and more stock.
The black market is open for business shipment. Make room for the profits.
We're not really using this hacker ray very much.
You caught a dirty rat trying to break our stuff? The black market is online.
Yes, more chemical optimizations and chems are still low. But he's not even in chems anymore. Network virus
our methods continue to
on
improve.
The off-world, along with a spy, forcing Rhahi to put the goon on it. Although Cubit's mutinies are really expensive, and thinking machines for EMPs. Well, Cubit has a spy, so Cubit can see that. Another off-world coming up for Cubit, but Rhahi already has that location spied out. And Cubit probably should have been aware of that after the mutinies going on the patent lab in that location. EMP on the off-world, and Cubit conceding. But Cubit should have been able to see that, though, with the spy. Well played, close game by Rhahi here, neck and neck for quite a long time, and then Rhahi pulling ahead into the end, in part because of a slight claim advantage, I still think, in terms of auction to tiles. But also, and largely in part, due to the very good mutiny goon play against Cubit's buildings throughout the game, that had to be quite annoying to play against. Every building that was mutinied had a goon, and Cubit kept on donating those expensive mutinies over to Rhahi for Rhahi to use against Cubit's buildings later. Production and sales pretty even across the board. Cubit making selling a lot more in glass than Rhahi did, but the balance sheet should tell the story here. Rhahi making, well, not that much more money, actually, to be honest. Nope. Not sure that the sheet shows the value of these resources or not, the endgame sheet. I know Mohawk was thinking about adding that, but not sure if they did. So that might be where the discrepancy is coming from. Anyway, well-played game series from both of our players. Rhahi taking two well-deserved wins.